Well, today we will be learning about the next topic, that is ray optics and optical instruments. So, wishes to all the students. So, let us start the discussion. Ray optics and optical instruments starts with the concept of ray optics, that is a branch of optics which is developed on the basis of rectilinear propagation of light, and it deals with the So, well, we discuss with the law of reversibility, which states that after n number of reflection and refractions, if the direction of light ray is reversed, it will retrace its whole path. Now, law of reflection at a smooth surface. So, we are having basically two laws, the incident ray, the normal ray, and the reflected ray. They all lie in the same plane, and the angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So, here, once the reflection will take place through a plane surface, then deviation produced will be 180 minus 2i. And when the reflection is produced twice through a plane mirror, then it will be 360 minus 2 theta. So for maximum deviation, we are having I equals to 0, that is for a ray moving along the normal. Now moving further, coming to the phenomena of reflection. So when the reflection is taken place from denser surface, so there will be phase change of pi degree, or pi radians, or lambda by 2. When it is taken from rarer surface, so then there will not be any change in the path phase difference. And whereas when during reflection, the frequency, the wavelength, and the speed of light will remain same, they will not change. In plane mirror, we will observe that the image will be laterally inverted, object distance will be equal to image distance, height or size of image will be equal to size of object. Next, further, we will be having the image will be laterally inverted and vice versa. Sometimes we observe that if the watch is kept in front of a mirror, then the actual time in the watch will be equal to 11 hours 60 minutes minus the time observed in the image of the watch. So that is how we get the actual time there. So this is how we can go ahead with it. So now keeping the incident ray fixed, if you rotate a mirror by an angle theta, then the reflected ray is rotated by an angle 2 theta. If there are three mutually perpendicular mirrors and they are placed adjacent to each other, then for a person standing in front of them, total number of images formed will be 7. Now for two mirrors, if they are inclined at an angle theta, then the number of images formed will be 360 by theta minus 1. If 360 by theta is even number, 360 by theta minus 1, when 360 by theta is odd number and the object is placed symmetrically, 360 by theta, when 360 by theta is an odd and the object is placed unsymmetrically. Now here what will happen is further, we have spherical mirrors, and for the formation of, there will be two types of spherical mirrors. One is concave mirror, the other will be convex mirror. Now there will be few rules for the image formation. So we consider here four rays. The ray first parallel to the principal axis will pass through the focus, and the ray which is passing through the focus will become parallel to the principal axis after reflection. The ray which is passing through center of curvature will retrace its own path after reflection, and the ray which is incident at an angle of incidence I at the pole will be reflected at the same angle of incidence and will be reflected there. So now these are the four rays. So where these four rays will actually meet, we call that point as the image formation point. And here there are some relations of for spherical mirrors. First is F equals to R by 2, 1 by F equals to 1 by V plus 1 by U, that is mirror formula. Magnification M equals to I by O, that is size of the image divided by size of the object, which is equal to minus V by U. Sometimes if they don't give you U or V, so then you can use the alternate formula, that is F minus V by F and for F divided by F minus U. So magnification is negative for inverted image and positive for erect image. Focal length of mirror will remain unaffected when dipped in liquid. Now further, when you are having concave mirror, you will be having different cases there, six different cases. When the in all the cases, the image formed will be inverted. First five cases, the image formed will be real and inverted, except the last case. So when the object is at infinity, the image will be formed at focus. When the object is in between F and C, the image will be formed beyond C. When the object is at C, the image will be formed at C. When the object is between F and C, then the image is formed beyond C. Next you are having when the object is at F, then the image will be formed at infinity. And when the object is between F and P, that is the only case where the virtual image will be formed and should be formed behind the mirror. Now moving further, in case of convex mirror, there will be two cases. One is when the object is at infinity, and the second case when the object is in front of the mirror. When the object is at infinity, the image will be formed at focus, and in both the cases, the image formed will be virtual, erect, and diminished image. And in front of the mirror, when the object is kept at anywhere on the principal axis, then the image will be formed in between P and F. Now here we are having a refraction phenomena, that is real depth and apparent depth concept or normal shift. So basically, whenever an object or observer is standing in a rarer medium and observing a object in a denser medium, so then it is observed that there will be apparent shift in the position of an object normally. So this shift we call it as normal shift. So it is given by, say, from the diagram you can see OP by mu 2, that is the refractive index of second medium, equals to PI by mu 1. So here the ray is going from medium 2 to 1. You should keep this in mind. So then we will be having PI equals to mu 1 by mu 2 OP, which is equal to mu 1 by mu 2 into x. So when the ray is going from medium 1 to medium 2, you are having OP by mu 1 equals to PI by mu 2. So PI equals to mu 2 by mu 1 into OP, which is mu 2 by mu 1 into x. So there is slight difference. So this is how some kinds of problem, like we are having a problem which is given below, the bird and fish problem famously called. So popularly this problem can be solved by this method. The velocity of the image will be mu 2 by mu 1, and velocity of the image in first case will be mu 1 by mu 2. So velocity of the object will be also considered here. So this is how it is. Next, coming to the lateral shift, when there is the sideways displacement of an incident ray when it passes through a parallel sided glass slab, then the shift is called as lateral shift, that is sideways shift. The formula for lateral shift is given by T into sine of I minus R divided by cos R, where T is the thickness of the slab, I is the angle of incidence, and R is the angle of refraction. For small values of I, we are having the lateral shift at T, or say lateral shift L, which is given by T into 1 minus 1 by mu. So this is another formula. So when I moves to I max, so then I will be equals to 90 degree, and that is how different cases we will be getting here. So there will be shift in the position. The shift in position will, lateral shift will be given by 1 minus 1 by u, or that is 1 minus 1 by refractive index. So different cases are given here. We can go through it. Next, coming to the refraction critical angle. So here, total internal reflection phenomena we are about to describe. So here what will happen is, as the angle of incidence increases, there will be one particular angle of incidence for which the angle of reflection in the denser medium will be 90 degrees. So the ray must travel from rarer to denser medium. So that angle of incidence, we call it as critical angle. And it depends upon the pair of media. So here we are having the formula, say sine IC will be equal to mu 1 by mu 2. So TIR is taking place when two conditions are satisfied. First is the ray must travel from denser medium to rarer medium. And the second case, the angle of incidence must be greater than the critical angle. So here when a fish is seeing the sky, it will be seeing in the form of cone. So the radius of the cone R will be equal to h divided by root of 1 minus mu square, where mu is the refractive index of water. And h is the height of the depth of the fish from the surface of the water. So further, you are having the application of TIR, as you can see, in optical fiber. So it is having two different coverings. One is core, the other is cladding. So if you observe here, the refractive index mu 1 is greater than the refractive index mu 2. So core is having high refractive index when compared to cladding. As the ray will travel from core to clad, so it will suffer TIR, and it will be reflected back to the core back again. And this is how the signals will travel. So if a ray at a core at an angle less than theta, it will suffer multiple total internal reflections. And the core and theta is here called as angle of acceptance here. Many a times we calculate this angle of acceptance in our numericals. So it is given by sine theta A, which is equal to root of mu 1 square minus mu 2 square divided by mu 0. So this is the formula to calculate it. Now, spherical refracting surfaces, gas, glass, sphere in air. So we can go ahead with this. Here you can observe our formula for this will be slightly different. So here we see it will be N2 minus and mu 2 by V minus mu 1 by U equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by R, where R is the radius of curvature, V is the image distance, and U is the object distance. Mu 2 and mu 1 are the refractive indexes of the glass and the outer surface, surrounding surface respectively. So now here, glass sphere, when you consider, we observe that we can solve it. So total deviation produced, angle of incidence if it is alpha and angle of refraction if it is beta. So from the diagram we get as a total deviation as a 2 into alpha minus beta. So this is a shortcut formula to remember here. So moving here, rules for the image formation for lenses. In the same way, we can calculate it as we have seen for mirrors. So here, when we are having two types of lenses, one is converging lens, the other is diverging lens. So same type of diagrams will be there. Only thing is, here we'll be having two surfaces. But here, the converging lens, that is convex lens, will behave as say like that of a concave mirror, and the concave lens will be behaving it as like a convex mirror. So it is vice versa. Other than that, the things will remain same here. So we are having lens formula, that is 1 by V minus 1 by U equals to 1 by F. Then you are having magnification I by O. So here, the formula, shortcut formula for magnification will be V by U, or F divided by F plus U, or F minus V by F. So further, we are having a convex mirror. So in case of convex mirror, the things will change. The image formed will be virtual image, because here you will observe that it will be similar to that of the virtual image can be photographed as camera lens forms a real image of this. So we are having a lens, a converging lens. So that is the reason, even though the object image formed is virtual, it can be caught in the photograph, but it can be seen also, but it cannot be caught on the screen. So this is the speciality of the virtual image. Now moving further, you are having the concept of lateral magnification. So lateral magnification is the magnification with the when the object is kept with its length along the principal axis. You are having in the diagram, you can see. So it will be a dash b dash divided by ab. So vb by minus va divided by ua minus cb. So that is how we get the formula. For a short object, ml will be equal to, that is lateral magnification will be equal to dv by du. So lens and mirror, we are having it as a combination of these two. So in that case, a point object is placed in front of a convex lens. A convex mirror is placed behind the lens. So the final image coincides with the object itself. So in that case, what will happen is we are having the diagram as shown here. So this is how it will be, case one, case two. So object itself can see the, if the observer is at the place of object, he can see the image at that place itself when this condition is satisfied. Now lens maker's formula for thin lenses, it will be 1 by f equals to say mu 2 1 minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. So 1 by f is also called as power. So reciprocal of focal length it will be. So depending upon that, we are having different cases. So we can go ahead with the sign convention. So we are familiar with the sign convention. As it is not mentioned in the sign slides, I will be just going to the recap of that. So here the rays which will be traveling in the direction of incident ray will be taken as positive, opposite to the direction of incident ray will be taken as negative. The rays will be, the distances will be measured along the principal axis. The distances measured above the principal axis will be positive and below the principal axis will be negative. So that is how we go ahead here, and we can substitute the values and calculate the things here. So now there are different types of lenses. So radius of curvature for all the lenses will be different. Surfaces will be different. So in this slide, we can go ahead. Plano convex lens, R1 is plus R, R1 is infinity. And similarly, vice versa, R2 will be infinity, R2 will be equal to minus R. So that is how it is. So plano concave lens, then you are having. In that case, you can calculate the values. So 1 by F equals to mu minus 1, 1 by R. F 1 by F equals to mu minus 1, minus 1 by R, plano concave. Next, equiconvex, you are having mu minus 1 into 2 by R. And mu minus 1 into minus 2 by R for equiconcave. Then concave or convex, and convex or concave, and sunglasses. So the different parameters are given to you. Just we need to substitute. So next, coming to the combination of lenses. So in contact, when we take, so 1 by F equals to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. So P will be equal to P1 plus P2, where P is taken with sign. That is for convex, the power will be positive because we are having it as converging. By convention, we are having it. And for concave, it will be taken as negative. So if at all there is separation between the two lenses, so then P will be equal to P1 plus P2 minus D P1 P2. So this is the formula which is applicable only for parallel rays. Now moving further, so cutting of lenses. So the lens can be cut into following ways. So when it is cut along the longitudinally, so then the focal length will be two times individual, so 2F and 2F. So when it is thrust again perpendicularly, then it will be 2F, 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 4 pieces will be getting it. So when it is cut transversely, so you will be having the focal length remaining same. So then when it is cut again longitudinally, so then what will happen is the focal length will become half of it. So this is how here it will be. Now here you are having it, the convex lens made up of more than one material may have more than one focal length. The number of focal lengths will be equal to number of different medium, that is equal to number of images per medium, that is C. There is single focal length, only one image. So then two images, two focal length, then one image, one focal length. So this is how the things will be. Now types of lenses, silvering of a lens is an important concept so for many competitive examination. So types of lens, surface silvered, focal length after silvering, and nature of lens after silvering is given to you. So plano convex, when you take, F will be equal to R divided by N minus 1. So it will be F by 2, and concave mirror it will be. So similarly, you are having f equals to r divided by n minus 1, so spherical. And next you are having r by 2n for concave mirror. Next, similarly, it remains same for plano convex, plane and spherical. So by convex, you are having then one surface r divided by 2 into n minus 1. So r divided by 2 into 2n minus 1, concave mirror literally. Then plano concave, f equals to r divided by n minus 1. So when you surface the plane surface silver, so then you have f by 2 will be the focal length and it will be behaving as convex mirror. So plano concave, f equals to r divided by n minus 1, spherical. So here, when you silver spherical surface, so r divided by 2n will be your new focal length and it will be convex mirror. Next, you are having f equals to r into 2 into n minus 1 on surface, so then it will be following concave mirror. Now you are having when a convex lens is placed on a plane mirror of the and the image on of an object coincide with it, then the focal length of the lens will be equal to height of the object, as the image will coincide the object only if the rays after passing through the lens become parallel to the principal axis. So that is how the equation will be. Now next you are having prism. So we are having prism formula. So one is delta equals to I plus E minus A. Next you are having A equals to R1 plus R2. So we are having I mu equals to sine E by sine R2, which is sine I1 or sine of A plus B by 2 divided by sine of A by 2. So this formula we call it as prism formula and it is for the minimum deviation. So next you are having thin prisms, and for thin prisms we are having our formula for deviation as N minus 1 into A or mu minus 1 into A. So that is how it is. So here there are a few cases. If angle of the prism is greater than 2 times the critical angle, so then mu will be greater than cosec A by 2, so there will be no emergent light whatever will be the angle of incidence. So A equals to 2C is called limiting value of the angle of prism. And if A is less than C, then total internal reflection at second surface can never take place. So for incident ray to reach its path after reflection from second phase, R2 should be equal to 0 and R1 should be equal to A. So mu will be equal to sine I by sine A. And angle of deviation is maximum and the angle of incidence is 90 degrees. So this is the condition. Now coming to dispersion phenomena. So we are having Cauchy's formula and dispersion. So mu equals to A plus B divided by lambda square plus C divided by lambda to the power 4 plus D divided by lambda square to the power 6. Where A, B, C, D are called as Cauchy's constant. So this is also the relation between refractive index and wavelength. So other than that, you are having angular dispersion theta equals to deviation for violet ray minus deviation for red ray. So theta will be equal to angle of deviation, theta will be also equals to nv mu v minus mu r into a, that is refractive index of violet minus refractive index for red into angle of prism. So dispersive power is theta and it is angular dispersion divided by delta. So it will be mu v minus mu r into a divided by mu minus 1 into a. So e and a gets cancelled, you are left with mu v minus mu r divided by mu minus 1. Now for dispersion without deviation, delta will be 0. So mu minus 1 into a plus mu dash minus 1 into a dash will be equal to 0. For deviation without dispersion, theta will be equal to 0. So mu v minus mu r into a plus mu v dash minus mu r dash into a dash will be equal to 0. Now lenses in contact, so power will be equal to 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2. Condition for achromatism, omega 1 by f1 plus omega 2 by f2 will be equal to 0. Or omega 1 p1 plus omega 2 p2 will be equal to 0, where omega 1 omega 2 are the angular dispersions. So now similarly, we can also calculate the condition for achromatism in the above case. So it will be d equals to omega 1 f2 plus omega 2 f1 divided by omega 1 plus omega 2. So this is how it will be. So now coming to the optical instrument, simple microscope, magnifying glass. So we are having m equals to d by u, where d is the distance between the least distance of distinct vision it will be, and u will be the distance of the object. So for relaxed eye, the image will be at infinity. For strained eye, the image will be at d. So in that case, if for an image at infinity, m will be equal to d by f, and for the image at d, m will be equal to 1 plus d by f. So next we are having compound microscope. So it will be using two lenses, one is objective, the other is eyepiece, and they are placed with respect close to each other. Then we are having magnification of compound microscope as m0 equals to minus v0 by u0 negative, and m e will be equal to d divided by mu. So case 1, case 2, two cases are there. First the image is formed at infinity, second the image is formed at d. In that case, for a relaxed eye, m will be equal to minus v0 by u0 into d by fe, or minus, which is nearly equal to minus l by f0 into d by fe. For a strained eye, it will be minus v0 by mu0 u0, so 1 plus a d by fe, or minus l by f0, 1 plus d by fe. So this is the case here. Now coming to the astronomical telescope, so length of the tube L will be equal to f0 by fe, f0 plus fe, and m will be equal to minus f0 by fe. That is the for normal adjustment, the magnification will be given by this. And for strained eye, it will be m equals to minus f0 by fe, 1 plus fe by d. Length of the tube will be less than F0 plus FE. So this is all about your rheo optics. Thank you.